A drug is eliminated from the body through urine. Suppose that for a dose of 10 milligrams, the amount A remaining in the body T hours later is given by the amount is equal to 10 times 0.8 raised to the T power, and that the drug to be effective at least 2 milligrams must be in the body. Part A, determine the time when 2 milligrams are left in the body. So basically 2 milligrams here is the value of the A in this case. So we have to substitute the A for 2 for part A to solve for the T. The T is going to be the time, right? So this is obviously what we have to solve for to determine the time. So 2 is set equal to 10 times 0.8 to the T power. So first divide both sides by 10. It will be 2 divided by 10 is 0.8 to the T power. So the left side, using the GCF 2 for both 10 and 2, you know that it reduces to 1/5. Is equal to 0.8 t. Now I'm going to take logarithm on both sides. So the log of 1 over 5th is equal to log of 0.8 to the t. And as you know, the left side is not going to be touched, but the right side, the exponent comes down. So whenever you have the logarithm of the input raised to a certain exponent, that exponent, in this case t, will go down. So it's going to be t times log of 0.8. So dividing both sides by log of 0.8 isolates the t and solves for it at the same time. So this is equal to t is equal to log of 1/5 divided by log of 0.8. Okay, and of course this means you might be tempted to write it like this, which you would not be incorrect. But if you, unless you have a calculator that can do that, some calculators can, there's no necessity, right? There's no need to do that, right? So you can just input this in the calculator and you will get the result. So let's see what the calculator does. 1/5 log divided by 0.8 log of that. So it's going to be 7.212567439, which to, let's say, two decimal places to the nearest 1/100th is going to be 7.21. And what is the units for t? The t is hours, right? It says hours, right? So that's going to be hours. So in about 7 hours there will be the least number of milligrams for the drug to still be effective, right? That's the least value that it can have, right? That's what's indicated. So in 7 hours, basically in 7 hours, the drug will start to be ineffective. Part B says, what is the half-life of the drug? Now, half-life of the drug means the time it takes for exactly 1/2 of the drug to be absorbed and to be gone, basically, right? So the time it takes for 1/2 of the original amount of drug to be remaining in the body, right? So in this case, what is the original? The original is 10 milligrams, right? That's how much you intake, let's say. That's the intake you have originally, 10 milligrams, and you have 1/2 of it left, right? So we have to divide 10 by 2, and that's going to be the same thing. We're going to solve for A, and that's going to be set equal to 10 times 0.8 to the t. So now we know that 10 divided by 2 is 5, right? That's going to be equal to this. And then we're going to divide by 10 again. So 5 over 10 is 0.8 t. 5 over 10 is 1/2, right? So 1/2 is equal to 0.8 t, and again we're going to use logarithms. Take logarithms on both sides, you're going to get this, right? And now of course the t will go down, right? So log of 1/2 is equal to t times log of 0.8, and then you can isolate the t by dividing both sides by log of 0.8. So log of 1/2 divided by log of 0.8. So obviously, the answer has to be smaller than 7 hours, right? Because in seven hours, the drug will be ineffective and it will be 2 milligrams. But 1/2 of 10 milligrams is 5, right? 5 milligrams is exactly 1/2 of the original amount. So now, using the calculator, what are you going to have? You're going to have log of 1/2 divided by log of 0.8. That's going to give you 3.10628372. To 2 decimal places is 3.11. And it makes sense, right? It's hours again, because this is the time, right? The half-life is talking about the time it takes for 1/2 of the original amount of the drug to remain in the body, right? So in 3 hours, there will be exactly 1/2, 5 milligrams left in your body if you take 10 milligrams. So, and it's consistent what we've suspected before, that it has to be smaller than the 7 hours that we had for the 2 milligrams to remain. Okay, so I hope this was a lot of fun. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.